working siguro for 2 decades, almost 20 years sa simbahan. Ako naman po, 30 years. Si Father Mark po, 56 years sa priesthood. And 55 of them dito sa Pilipinas. Tama ba? He was born po, ay, He was ordained po during Vatican Mother, Vatican II, Vatican II. Ang mission po ng buka is to journey with people towards a participatory church in the world. So coming po from Las Piñas, pastoral work in the parish, we set up buka ng Tipan 17 years ago. And we work po with different dioceses in the Philippines, ganun din po sa Asia at sa Europe. Bukal po is part of the bishops' conferences in the Philippines, sa BEC desk, at saka sa youth desk. Ganun din po sa BEC desk, at saka youth desk ng Asian bishops' conferences. It is our pleasure po to be with you. Salamat po for trusting us for this retreat. Ang tema po ng retreat natin, leading the journey towards a communion of communities in mission. Alam po namin na patapos na ang taon, and you must have been reflecting on this for a whole year and are about to close, ano, in 2 months, the celebration of this pastoral theme. Pero para sa amin po, it's not just a pastoral theme for the year. Ang tingin talaga namin, it is linking all the themes, and it's actually a common framework for leadership building na siyang pinapangarap when the pastoral themes were designed by the Catholic bishops. Conferences po, ano? Kaya po, adibig tayo to reflect even further and hopefully add on to your own reflections. So, itong mga araw na ito, we hope to personally own itong word na to, communion and mission. Today is basically that. It is basically po a reflection at a personal level and personal experiences ano ba yung communion and mission na yan. At since ang theme po is about leading it, kayo po ang mga parapare has this leadership role, ang main talks po will really focus on leadership. Today po, after a personal reflection, tomorrow po is where does the authority of your own leadership come from pag pinag-usapan natin yung communion of communities in mission. At tumuha po tayo ng inspiration mula dun sa online communities, the early Christian communities. Kasi sila naman talaga yung communion of communities in mission that inspire us. So based on that experience, ano ba yung leadership authority niyo? On the last day po, ang focus naman natin is you as a leadership community, yung buong clergy community in mission. Saan ang galing yung leadership energy ng clergy community? Sabi ko po kahapon, tatlo parang ang input per day ng retreat na ito. The first one comes from the Word of God. Let the Word of God talk. It is a living word. Kaya ang umpisa po natin parate is a reflection on the Word of God. And we prepare our hearts to listen to it. Yan ang parating umpisa ng umaga, biblical reflection. Pero syempre po, because it is a living word, it also dialogues with your own experience. So kayo ang pangalawang input ng retreat na ito. Your own experiences, dialoguing with the living word, is definitely a deep resource para sa ating retreat. That will be the morning po, pangatong input ay sa amin, sharing our own experiences po dito sa area. So syempre po, lalo na si Father Mark as a priest. Everyone po receives the schedule. So, alam na po natin how the day will flow, the Eucharistic celebrations, the sessions, the Sacrament of Reconciliation tomorrow. So, if you have picked up about the day, every day po, I give a bit about the day so that we are prepared for the day. Today's journey po. Maikita na journey pero pwede mahaba from head to heart. Sabi ko, sabi ko, ako dito sa po ito, para kung saan nandito dito, you may want to learn a bit. Sabi po nila, it's a short journey, but it will also be a long journey from head to heart. Katulad ko na nabanggit ko kanina, we hope to define communion at a personal, heart personal experiences of Holy Grupo. Right after this reflection on Acts 4, a very popular, very familiar description of the Eucharist, of the Christian community, we go into a sharing or reflection on the joys and pains of communion. At sana po, mag-open tayo kasi resource naman talaga yung aking mga karanasan. And in the afternoon po, kami naman po, we'll also share our personal experience of communion and mission. At syempre po, we end the day with the Eucharistic celebration. Between the talk and the Eucharist po, we have a silence and adoration of the Blessed Sacrament, Masarap Tumahimik, after all the sharing that we will hear in a particular day. So, ganun po ang ating araw. Let's have a moment of silence na po to prepare ourselves para sa araw na ito and to ask for God's guidance. We all face the center po, please. We are not using Google.
As Stella po mentioned, our first input would be a personal reflection on the Word of God. And we would like to start off with a chant. Ewan mo lang po, familiar kayo with this chant. Where two or three are gathered together in my name, I shall be there among them in their midst. May kilang po, very familiar yung words at tono po niya. Where two or three are gathered together in my name, I shall be there among them in their midst. Lahat po tayo. Where two or three some prayer, and then after the prayer, we'll read our Bible reflection for the day. So again, let's just pause for a few moments of silence. Let's just bow down our heads and close our eyes and remember that we are in God's holy presence. And as we prepare our hearts and our minds to encounter the Lord through His Word, let us sing the chant, or two or three, and we sing it three times.
Where to, O tree, are gathered together in my name, I shall be there among them in their midst. Where to,
but they had everything in common. great power, the apostles bore witness to the resurrection of the Lord. And great favor was accorded them all. There was no needy person among them, for those who owned property or houses would sell them. Bring the proceeds of the sale and put them at the feet of the apostles, and they were distributed to each according to need.
In front of us all are symbolic representations of the reading. In a few moments, I would invite each and everyone to kindly stand up and to interact with these different symbols. To interact means to dialogue with God through His Word through the different symbols that we see around us. Feel free to touch the symbol if you want. You can hold it, you can touch it, and you can even move it according to your reflection. For example, you can take a hand and put it here on the word. You can take some rice, put it on the other bowl, or take some rice and put it to the other symbols as you well please. But as you go through with the different symbols, we will invite you to just pause and allow each symbol to speak to you. Ano po kaya yung sinasabi ng bawat simbolo na ito sa iyo personally at this time? What does each symbol mean for you in your ministry, in your personal life, as you encounter, as you interact with the different symbols? We allow this to be our Bible sharing, a different way of sharing on the word through the different symbols that we see around us. We will do this in silence as we walk around. And again, feel free to interact with the symbols, touching it, holding it, moving it, transferring it if you want. Also as a way for us to represent that this story of the first Christian community is also our story. And it's also evolving, the story is continuing as we use the symbol, as we change the symbols. So may I invite you now to kindly stand up, tayo po tayong lahat, and for the next 5 minutes of silence, let's just go around and interact with these different symbols. We can do this for a lifetime.